Hi, I'm Peter Skinner, and today I'm going to talk to you about TecQuipment's expansion of a perfect gas that we have in front of us today. So the product consists of the main unit and a control box. The main unit, we have a pressure vessel and a vacuum vessel. Each of these vessels has a thermocouple inside and a pressure sensor connected. The two vessels are connected to the large bore pipe at the top, where you can have experiments between the two vessels or from the vessel to atmosphere, and that's either the pressure vessel to atmosphere or the vacuum vessel to atmosphere. The vessel is also connected through a small bore pipe and a needle valve here. This is for one particular experiment where we want to expand air from the pressure vessel through to the vacuum vessel very, very slow. Each vessel is also connected to a mechanical gauge, so you can see the pressure of each vessel even if the control box is not turned on. We also supply an ambient air temperature on the side of the unit here for reference. So all of these sensors are connected to the control box's front panel here. All the measurements are also displayed on the display here. The control unit also houses our VDAS hardware, so you can connect to a PC and to our VDAS software through a USB that's located on the rear of the control box unit. The control box also has some fast inputs on the right here. Some of the experiments happen very quickly, so we need to have some high rate sampling for those sensors. We also house an air pump inside the control box, where we have the ports here and the on-off switch on the front panel here. To connect your air pump to one of your vessels, take one of the supply tubes. The larger tube is to connect the pressure port to your pressure vessel. The third tube is to connect the vacuum port to your vacuum vessel. So take your tube, push it into the socket, and you feel it engage, and then if you pull it, it won't release. Take the other end and connect it to the self-sealing valve on the underside of your vessel. Again, push it in to feel it engage, and then give it a tug, and you'll see it has engaged with the tube. And then all you need to do is turn the pump on to pressurize your vessel. To disengage your tube, you need to push the little outer ring of the connector in and then pull the tube firmly. That is the same for both ends and both sides tubing. The valves on each of the vessels is a self-sealing, so you don't need to worry about closing any valves after you've reached your required pressure, or positive pressure or vacuum pressure. So the first experiment we're going to do here today is the Clement-Desormes experiment. With this experiment, we obtain a value for the specific heat capacity ratio of air. This is quite a common parameter used in many different subject areas, such as aerodynamics, gas turbine design. The stated value for this is 1.4 for air. To start this experiment, we need to make sure all of the valves on the unit are closed. Now we need to pressurise our pressure vessel to 0.3 bar, or 30 kilopascals. Once you have reached your desired pressure, it's always best to remove the tubing, especially from the vessel end first, as the air will leak through the tube and through the pump. Once we've reached our desired pressure, we need to ensure the air inside the vessel is the same as the ambient air outside. We can do this by looking at the temperature measured by the thermocouple thermocouple inside the vessel, compare it to the ambient thermocouple. Inside our VDAS software, we need to select the required experiment from the drop-down. We also can select the pressure vessel. So this particular experiment is experiment 2, and we are using the pressure vessel. For accurate results, it's always best to enter in today's ambient pressure. For this experiment, we utilise the fast inputs on the right of the control box. So we need to move our pressure sensor from the standard input to the fast input section. We are now ready to start the communication from the control box to the software. This yellow line represents the pressure inside the vessel. What I'm now going to do now is open this valve and close it quickly. The pressure inside the vessel will then drop. When I close the valve, the pressure will begin to rise. This is because when the pressure drops, the temperature drops based on our ideal gas equation. When we close the valve, we are under a constant volume. Because the air inside the vessel is now colder than the ambient air, it begins to warm. Going back to our ideal gas equation, temperature rises, so therefore the pressure must also rise since the volume can't change. This recovery from that, the lowest pressure we measure and the final pressure we measure when the air has finally has returned back to the ambient temperature are the key parameters we are going to measure. We will hear a loud burst as the air escapes from the vessel. Go back to our software. If we pause or if we stop the communications, we can go back and have a look at that trace. So like I said, our main measurements are the initial pressure and the lowest pressure we measure. So we can enter these in using the cursors and we see the value on the bottom of the screen here. So our initial starting pressure is 29.74. And then we use the cursors again to find the lowest point that we measure. So we just scroll back and forth to find the lowest point. We obtain 2.84. Now we need to restart the communication and wait until the air inside the vessel has returned to ambient temperature. This may take a few minutes. So what is an ideal gas? An ideal gas is where we assume the molecules of the gas have negligible mass, volume, and any collisions have no effect. A real gas, those assumptions are incorrect. There are molecules, they have mass, they have interactions with each other. In a lot of scenarios, it is a fair assumption to assume the gas is ideal. And this is what we are experimenting today. There are various processes and assumptions that we make, such as adiabatic, polytropic, and isochoric process throughout different experiments on this product. This product is fundamental in thermodynamics and also covers the first and second laws of thermodynamics. It also complements Boyle's law and Gay-Lussac products that are also available from TecQuipment. Now our temperature inside our vessel has reached ambient temperature, we can now take our final measurement. We can see here we've obtained a value for the specific heat capacity ratio of 1.37. This is very close to the stated value of 1.4. This particular experiment, we have assumed that the process is reversible. A second experiment that's very similar, where we assume the process is irreversible, allows us to prove our assumptions on this experiment. The second experiment we're going to show to you today is one where we pressurize our pressure vessel and our vacuum vessel, and then we expand the air very slowly from this vessel into this vessel through an isochoric process. So with this, we are going to open this needle valve very, very slowly so the air ignores any friction as it passes from one vessel to the other. we can take our initial pressures and our final pressure and obtain the volume ratio between the two vessels. So for this, I shall now pressurise and vacuum the two vessels. So now we have pressurised and vacuumed our vessels to our desired pressures, we select experiment 4 from the drop down in our VDAS software. This doesn't utilise the faster inputs, so we move all of our sensors back to the standard ports. So we record our starting pressures into the spin boxes here. And now we open this valve so slowly that the temperatures inside these vessels do not change. We also have to open the two valves here and here. This experiment will take 15 to 30 minutes. Now that our pressures have equalised between the two vessels, we can take our final pressure and enter it into the VDAS software. We obtain a value of 1.95 against a nominal value of 1.99, so we get quite very close results. Thank you for watching TecQuipment's video on the expansion of a perfect gas.